हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डीवीडीटी लिमिटेशंस ऑफ एससीआर एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 46520। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स वर्किंग। नाउ लेट्स सी द कंपोनेंट्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द किट। सो दिस इज द इंटरनल 300 वोल्ट डीसी सप्लाई, देन दिस इज द एससीआर सर्किटरी, देन दिस इज द पुश बटन to trigger the SCR, then this is the potentiometer of 1 kilo ohm, then this is the jewel light indication to visualize SCR is fired or not, then this is the circuitry of SCR. So that's all the components of this kit. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to test DVDT estimation of the SCR. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the positive of internal DC supply to the positive DC, then we will connect the negative port with the negative of DC, then we will connect the R3 port with the capacitor, then we will connect the other capacitor with the R3 port, and we will connect the third capacitor with the R3 port like this. And now we will connect a milliampere ammeter across A1 and A. So the positive will be connected to the A1 and the negative will be connected to A. So that is how the connection is done. And now we will switch on the kit. And we have to keep this potentiometer at fully clockwise direction. And now we will trigger the SCR. So we will trigger by using this push button. So here you can see that when I press this push button, the SCR got triggered and we are getting current readings on the multimeter, and we can see that this jewel light is glowing. This indicates that SCR is triggered. Now we can remove capacitor one by one and we can see the changes. So here you can see that this is the current reading and this shows that SCR is triggered. And when we rotate this potentiometer, we can see that this SCR is not glowing. But when we rotate it in clockwise direction and we press this push button, the SCR got triggered and we can see the current readings there. We can also remove the second capacitor, and now we will press this push button so that the SCR got triggered and we can see the current on the ammeter and the jewel light indication on this. So that is how we can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to compare DVDT capability by gate cathode terminations. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the input DC supply from the internal DC supply that is provided on the kit. So we will connect the positive with the positive one and the negative with the negative one. Now we will connect the resistance with the capacitor, and we will again connect the resistance with the capacitor, and now we will again connect the resistance with the capacitor 7, and we will connect the milliammeter across A1 and A. So the positive will be connected to A1 and the negative will be connected to A, like this. And now we will connect the SCR2 gate with the G1, like this, and we will connect the K with the K1, like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will also connect with this port like this. And now we will switch on the kit and the potentiometer position is at clockwise. So we will press this push button to trigger the SCR and we can see that there is no change in the milliammeter and the jewel light is also not glowing. So this shows that SCR is not triggered. Now we will reduce the potentiometer value and we will reduce the capacitor one by one. So now we will rotate this potentiometer anti-clockwise direction and we have removed one capacitor and now we will see whether the SCR is triggered or not. So here we can see that the SCR got triggered as we have reduced the potentiometer by rotating it in anti-clockwise direction and we have removed one capacitor. Now we will remove the second capacitor and here we will see whether the SCR is triggered or not. So here we can see that the SCR got triggered, this jewel light indicates that, and we can see the current in the multimeter which is approx 31.1 milliampere. Now we will reduce this potentiometer value again and we will press this button so that the SCR got triggered and here we can see that the current reading is 30.8 milliampere and this jewel light indicates that SCR got triggered. So as we reduce the potentiometer value, the current value also decreases. Here you can see that. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study DVDT capability by gate cathode biasing voltage biasing. So for that the connections will be remain same as the earlier experiment, just we need to do some changes in this connections, like we have to connect K and K2. So we will connect K and K2 and we have to connect G1 and G2 like this. And now we will connect the DC power supply which vary from 0 to 30 volt. We will connect it across K1 and K2. So the positive will be connected to K1 and the negative will be connected to K2 like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit. We have to keep the potentiometer at fully clockwise direction and now we have to give 10 volt from the DC power supply. Now we will switch on the kit and we have to keep the potentiometer at clockwise direction and now we will rotate it in anti-clockwise direction slowly and now we will press this push button to trigger the SCR and we have to give 10 volt DC supply across K1 and K2 by using this DC power supply. Now we will press this push button to trigger the SCR and here on the multimeter you can see that 33.9 milliampere current is showing and this jewel light is also glowing. This indicates that the SCR got triggered. Now you can vary the potentiometer and you can also reduce the capacitor and similarly you can perform this experiment and get different outputs. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to improve DVDT capability by transistor snubber circuit. So for that the connections will be remain same, just we need to do some changes in the circuit. So we have to connect A with the A3, we have to connect this A with the A3 and we have to connect the SCR second gate with the G3 and we have to connect the K with the K3. So this is the changes which we need to do. Now we will switch on the function generator and we will switch on the kit, but before that we have to keep this potentiometer at fully clockwise direction. And now we will connect the function generator to give the pulse. Now we have to switch on the kit and we have to give pulse. So we will use square wave of 2 VPP and we will connect it across the terminals R4 and capacitor C2 like this. And now we will adjust this potentiometer port. We will rotate it slowly in anti-clockwise direction. And now we will press this push button. And here you can see the light glowing and you can see the current on the milliampere, that is the 33.9 milliampere. So here we can see that the SCR got triggered. And similarly, you can rotate this potentiometer and take various outputs at different port positions. So that is how you can perform this experiment. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.